So hi guys, it's me Deepak, and this is the part 3 of how you can build your first app. This is a beginner video series, and in this video I'll be showing you how you can build your to-do list. So far we have built to-do list twice, first using text view and second using a list view. In text view we had an edit text where we used to write our tasks, then we press the button, we had an on click listener and which would save the task in our text view. There we used a save instance state and a restart state to save our strings, so that when we rotate our app, our task are not destroyed. We use a list view here in this app, and we were using an adapter, add adapter view, that was a inbuilt adapter, and storing our tasks in the form of list. So that was more like a traditional to-do list app, but the problem was we don't have an option to delete our tasks that we've written earlier. So for that I'll have a list view dot set item on long click listener. So if I pressed a task for a long period, so it will be deleted automatically, although I will not get a dialog box like if you really want to delete this list, but it will get the job done for a basic app. So here you have a on item long click listener, and you have to, and you will get option for, and you automatically create a override function that was on item long click. So Android Studio is really helpful in this. So I'll have a task list and I'll use a function remove, and I will remove that particular text view, and then I will have my task adapter, and I will notify the data set has been changed. So I'll have task adapter and dot notify data set changed. So this helps that it will notify that the data set has changed, and it will shift our text view upwards, backwards, depending. So let's turn the return to true. So if I press long enough, it will be deleted. So if I run the application, let's see. So there's an edit text and a button. And if I write a task like add task, and I press long enough, it should delete. So it works. Now second issue come that even if I am able to write the task, store it in a list view and delete as I wish, when I turn off this app, these strings, this array list are deleted. So to save these tasks in something like a text file, are you using file and file util? So I just want to tell you that when I am using a file util, I'm using an org apache common io import library that I have downloaded from internet. So I think you should also download from internet and just paste it in your library. I'll show you how, but first I should first create the read and write function. So the purpose of having read and write function is simple. To when I turn on my app, it will read the text files and see what strings are to be written, what strings are there, and it will write those array list, that array list, and use adapter view to write those in our list view. So it makes it simpler to store it in a text view so we can read it. And write statement is necessary because when I will delete or add new task, it will write those changes in our text view. So I'll have two functions here, private void read tasks and private void write tasks. It's better to create separate functions, as you can just call them whenever you want, then writing the whole set of operation every time you want those things to be done. So it's just a good practice, and I will be using more functions in future videos. So I think you should subscribe to the channel. Okay, so we have a file, and I'll be naming a file files. You should I should first stress that when you are using something like files or views, you should import. You have to import those things into your Android Studio. But if you press the Enter when a drop-down menu appear, it automatically write those import libraries in your Android Studio, so it makes it simpler. But if you write it down manually, it's not gonna import it. So it may give you a red color, indicating that it's not written. Okay, so files equal file dot get file directory. I'm getting the file directory here, and I will be using new files, and I'll be specifying the name to do text. The name should be same as we will be writing in our write task. So to do text, and will be mentioning the file directory as well as the name of the file. So I'll have a try and catch statement that if I didn't have the file, if there was an error, so I'll have an input exception, and I will just create an empty error list rather than to check the file. And when the first time you will be using this app, there is not going to be a text file here, so you need to create a new error list which will be empty. So task list equal error list, and we'll mention that it is a string. Just semi terminated, and here we'll be checking it. So there comes a tricky part here. Not the application, maybe. So task list equal new error list string. So I'll be using a file util here. So the file util I'm using is belonging to org apache common io. There are two actually, Android one and the Apache one. You should use the Apache one. If you have the option of Apache, consider yourself lucky. If you don't, then you have to download from internet, copy paste in your libraries, and then write a simple statement in your build Gradle. So here in libraries, you should paste it. If you just download it and paste it here, it's not difficult, and it's like not even a megabyte of file. And then in your dependencies, in your build Gradle, there are two build Gradles. You should click on the app one, where you can make changes. And here you should write the statement implementation files lib and switch the name and sync it. So this is what you need to do. And let's specify how we are going to write the task. So for writing the task, I should have files equal get file directory, and again making a new file, to do file, and new equal specifying the directory as well as the name should be same, and that is our to do text. So as I mentioned earlier, write task is necessary, because when we'll be adding new tasks or deleting new tasks, we need to notify the text file that we have made these changes, so that when we turn off our app and restart it again, it will have those saved changes in there. So we have to-do list here, to-do text, sorry. And now I need to have that try and catch statement again. If there is an input output exception here, I will print that exception this time, because then there's no need to create an error list. That will be created when we first start our app. So e dot print stack trace, it will print the error occurring. And you can always Google those error or in the Stack Overflow, in the Stack Overflow. Every error that you may encounter in this application, there someone had already encountered those errors. So I'll have file dot write lines, and there I will mention the to do file and to do list. And task list, that's our error list there. So it will make the changes in the task list. Now I need to mention, I need to have those callings. I need to have a real read task here, so I can call those functions. And similarly, in my on click listener, I'll have a write task. And so when I add a new task, I will write those changes in my text file, And similarly, when I delete, I need to write the changes in my text file again. So that's what need to be done, and it should run now. So if I check the emulator, you can actually build this app now and check on your phones and brag in front of your friends that I have built these applications. So you can see, if I even if I rotate this, the activity is not lost. In the first video, I have to use those two functions, save instance state and restart instance state. So we don't need to do this time, because we are still storing it in a text file. So even if we destroy our state when we rotate, it will just read it from the file and rewrite it. So it saves our time. And like I have a test tomorrow, I will decide in my text view or whatever. You need to pick something from the market or whatever you task you may have, you can write it in your own application. I'm actually looking for suggestions that you may have. I have few suggestions that like using a custom adapter, so such that I have a image view as well as text view, so I can in the images I can select the particular image. Like if you want to go to gym, you can have an icon of a gym. If you have a test mode, you can have an icon of study material or whatever you want. So I'm open for suggestions. You can also create another activity using intents. So I will be talking about those things in the future videos, and I'm open for your suggestions. So you should write that down in a comment section. And the next video will be about maybe a text classification app that will be using machine learning algorithms. So if you want, if you like this video, do consider subscribing, like the video, comment if you have any suggestions, if you get any error while running this application, write that down, and I will try to help you in the best way I can. So, and thanks for watching, guys. See you in my next video.